If you work in a grow house where they use high pressure sodium vapor lights like this, and you're shooting video, or you're shooting stills, you know that color correction is an absolute nightmare. Stick around, because I have a filter for you that's going to make your life a lot easier. First, we're obviously not in a grow house. We're in our studio back in the office. We tried doing this in a grow house and it just wasn't working. The audio is too difficult to manage, so we decided to bring it all in-house and make it a lot easier for you guys to learn about this filter. So why did we make this filter? The legalization of cannabis in North America continues to grow, and we're getting more and more phone calls from photographers, cinematographers, and social media managers asking if we make a filter that helps correct when they're shooting inside the grow houses, trying to capture pictures of live plants. What we do, we reached out to our engineers back in Japan, and they came up with this filter here. It's called a Grow Light Filter HPS. And anyone who's actually tried to actually capture live video or live stills using a high-end camera, or even just use their mobile phone, knows that once they get it in to fix for post, it is really, really difficult, near impossible, to correct for that yellow spike that's caused by the sodium vapor lights. The main issue with HPS lights, or high pressure sodium vapor lights, is that they give off such a strong yellow cast that when you try and color correct, even a custom white balance in camera, you just can't correct it accurately enough that it doesn't affect all the other colors in the scene. So as you can see in this, greens look green, oranges look orange, everything looks the way it's supposed to look, and we're really not doing anything more than setting the camera to incandescent mode in white balance and then letting the filter do the rest of the work. All right, so let's just look at a few before and afters. You can see in the videos and in the stills that adding the filter allows the camera to accurately white balance for the scene so that the colors look much more natural than they do if you did not use the filter. The only thing that you need to compensate for is the filter does reduce the overall exposure by about 2 stops. So you need to adjust your ISO or shutter speed or aperture, depending on your lighting situation, to compensate for that. Just remember, the filter, all it does is it blocks the yellow portion of the light so that it allows you to capture a much more accurate color rendition of the scene. Now, for those that use a mobile phone when they're working inside the grow houses, we've got a great solution for you. In combination with the right case, we use Moment lenses. The reason we use them, one, the lens optics are fantastic. It's a premium mobile phone lens company. In addition to that, they make an accessory that allows you to attach a filter to it. This filter adapter just attaches to one of their lenses, and then you can screw on any 62 millimeter threaded filter that you can buy, whether it be a UV, circular polarizer, and in this case, the Grow Light Filter HPS. Another cool thing from Moment is they've created a camera app, and that camera app is really robust. It allows us to control white balance, exposure, and focus manually. Being able to have those controls, especially in an environment like this, even with the filter, just makes things a lot easier and gets you a lot more accurate results than you'd get otherwise. Check out these before and after results. And note that these are straight out of the camera. We did nothing to color correct for any of these images. The filters come in 2 sizes, 82 millimeters and 62 millimeters, but they also come in a kit. And in that kit, we include 3 step-up rings. For the 82 millimeter, it covers 67 to 82, 72 to 82, and 77 to 82. In the 62 millimeter kit, we include a 49 to 62 millimeter, a 52 to 62 millimeter, and a 58 to 62 millimeter step-up rings. For those that are not familiar with step-up rings, let me show you how these work. All right, so this lens takes a 72 millimeter filter. So what we've done is we've grabbed the 72 to 82 millimeter step-up ring to use with the 82 millimeter filter. First thing we do is we attach the filter to the adapter ring, and then the next step is to attach that to the lens. So there you go, one filter can cover a multitude of different lenses. If the correct step-up ring that you need isn't included in the kit, they are readily available online, and at your local camera store. So that's it, the new Grow Light Filter HPS from Hoya. If you have any other questions, you can always reach us on Facebook, Instagram, or contact us direct through HoyaFilterUSA.com.